And listening to that report was Amy Geddes, who's an arable farmer in Arbroath in Scotland. Amy, good to have you with us today. We're talking today, of course, as the Met Office's State of UK Climate 2020 report comes out, which says there's more rainfall, more sunshine and higher temperatures. You're at the opposite end of the UK, basically, to those farmers. What sort of impacts from climate change have you noticed?
I think in terms of what we've seen locally here this year, it's been incredibly dry. And the extremes have been very noticeable. So we've gone from a terribly wet May into an incredibly dry June and July. I think we've had less than 20 millimetres of rain for both months. And that certainly has an impact, though not quite as sudden and devastating as the hail shower has had down south.
Mm. So what sort of crops do you grow and what impact is that having on those crops right now and in terms of your planning for what you're doing over the next few years?
Well, sticking with the theme of the oilseed rape crops, which are easily damaged at this time of year by the likes of heavy rain or torrential hail, our oilseed rape crops are very poor this year. That's been a combination of factors. I think insect and pest damage. We've all heard of the cabbage stem flea beetle, which we haven't been terribly bothered with, but it's starting to take effect. We've also seen incredibly cold, dry winter, which was preceded by an unprecedented rainfall event in October for us, after the crop was just a month or two sown. And the coldness we saw over the winter caused what we call frost heave. So the plants were effectively heaved out of the ground, which then also will affect the yield. And as it came into spring, again, we saw incredibly cold, dry weather followed by that terribly wet spell in May. And the crop itself just hasn't had a good year. And it does take a full year to come to fruition, to come to harvest. And a lot can happen in that time. So we will question now whether we continue to grow oilseed rape. I think we will this year. We've bought the seed. We're hoping for a better season. And we will continue to think of alternatives that might replace that in our rotation.
The report talks about, and it's talking about trees and shrubs here, but presumably one can extrapolate to arable crops to some extent as well, how plants are responding to climate change. So in spring, leaves appearing on average 10.4 days earlier. In autumn, trees going bare on average 4.3 days earlier. So as you look to the future and changing crops potentially, how challenging is it going to be to adapt? And obviously the margins in farming are pretty tight anyway. What are the financial challenges in all of that as well?
I think the immediate financial challenge is dealing with these unprecedented events. So whether that's incredible hail, torrential rain, unseasonable wind. And I think these things have happened in the past, but they are happening more frequently. And farmers are on the ground and they're seeing that happening in front of their eyes. And that will factor in their consideration as to what type of crops they grow. Plant breeding has a lot to do with it. I think we, as a nation, have great scientific institutes. You look at, for example, the James Hutton Institute near us at Dundee. And I think we will rely and should cooperate far more closely with these institutes to look to plant breeding and what might be more suitable in the future for growing on our farms, whether that's here in Scotland or further south where the forecast temperature increase is greater. So yes, there's a lot we can plan to do, but dealing with the immediate effects can be very difficult. And I think farmers will need support for dealing with that.
OK, Amy, thank you very much for giving us an insight into how the climate is affecting your work. Amy Geddes there, arable farmer in Arbroath.